Hello and welcome back to our second installment of a wonderful program here at Bethel Park TV, focusing on a program called All of Us, Pennsylvania. I'm happy to meet again with my two wonderful guests, Kirsten Carroll from the University of Pittsburgh and Amy Shore, research coordinator here at the Bethel Park site of All of Us, Pennsylvania. We're going to be talking more about what All of Us, Pennsylvania is. And with the help of these special guests, we're going to be learning about this exciting health initiative from the National Institute of Health that aspires to enlist more than 1 million volunteers to enable a new era in medicine. And hopefully many of you will want to participate today. So let's get to it and learn more about it.
So much of what we've done in medicine over the years has not really taken into account individual differences. We're really building a fundamental base of knowledge about how humans stay healthy or get sick and what to do about it. I think the practice of medicine will be altered in profound ways.
Moms, dads, brothers, sisters, people who are healthy, people who are sick, we want to work with you and make our lives better.
The whole idea of precision medicine is to be able to use individual differences to tailor prevention care that they receive.
We're building a set of capabilities with 1 million or more volunteers to figure out how do we enable targeted, customized care for an individual based on as much data as we can get about them.
I'm very excited about having 1 million people in a cohort. It gives us the ability to look at not just common diseases, but rare diseases. When you have 1 million people, even a rare disease, it may affect 100 people.
This is something that we are invested in, and we want everybody who has a perspective to be able to share that perspective.
The more diverse representation we have, the better outcomes we can give back to the public.
Being able to bring communities of color, not only to contribute to science, but to contribute to our ability to understand the nuances within those populations.
It is important for minorities to be a part of this, or we will again be left with medications that are created for really other populations.
It's definitely important to have participant engagement and individuals being partners from the ground up.
With all of the information that we're going to garner from this study, it is going to help with prevention. Prevention is really what the key right now to longevity.
It's about health, it's about disease, it's about behavior, it's about environment. Why not? You know, why not participate? Why not be part of it?
Well, I'm so happy you're here today, Amy.
Thank you for inviting me.
Welcome to the Bethel Park community as well. Mm-hmm. I know you're here working every day.
Yep.
And you'll be hopefully meeting many of our residents.
We have so far. We're doing well.
Wonderful.
We're doing well.
I want to ask you, what is your impression and description of All of Us, Pennsylvania?
So, All of Us, Pennsylvania is part of a national study called the All of Us Research Program. Mm-hmm. The All of Us Research Program is a national effort to build a research database that is rich in diversity and health information. One of the goals of the study is to build this database with 1 million or more people from across the country. We want to get a representation of the diversity of the population of the United States.
That's quite a goal, isn't
yes,
it?
Yes, yes.
And how long are you giving yourselves to get all those 1 million people?
Well, initially it was set for a 5-year study, uh-huh. but they are going to increase that time, especially being that we had this pause with the COVID vaccine.
Exactly.
So what we want to do is support researchers in their own research. So this is not an actual research study. This is providing tools for researchers to do their own studies so that they can better understand health conditions and diseases.
Yeah, it's wonderful. So it doesn't really focus on just one disease. It can be used, the information is going to be used to study many, many things.
Correct, correct.
That's great. And what is medical research?
So medical research is a process of learning how to better treat illnesses and diseases. Mm-hmm. So traditionally in research, how research is done now is that a researcher has to pick or choose what they want to study, and it's usually one disease or one topic. Mm-hmm. Then they have to find funding for their study, be approved for their study, then they have to gather eligible participants, then they have to gather all the data from those participants, do their analysis, and then present to the research and medical communities. That process can take a very long time.
I'm sure.
5, 10, sometimes longer. And with the all of us, we will have this rich database from diverse communities that researchers can access to do their analysis. This will cut the research time almost in half. Researchers will use this database to find better diagnoses, find better treatments, and also better use of medication.
Mommy, it's coffee time!
Coffee time!
Coffee time.
Welcome back to Coffee Break with me, Dr. Mylinda Massart from the University of Pittsburgh and UPMC. And today we're talking about research, a topic near and dear to my heart.
Hey Mom, what is research? Isn't that what you do?
Yes, Chaim. Research is one of the many things that I get to do in my job. Research is defined as the systematic investigation or study of materials and sources to establish facts and reach new conclusions. So, if I have a scientific or health-related question, I can design a research project to answer that question.
I think I'm going to design a research survey to see how all of my family likes their coffee. Ew, that's disgusting. How do they drink that?
There are many different kinds of research. There's research in the social sciences, in best business practices. You can even do research on how to make a book report. In the medical sciences, we think of two kinds of research, basic science or applied and translational research. Basic research is to understand fundamental principles. The goal of basic research is to find an answer to a question, not necessarily to have a direct or immediate benefit. This kind of research rises out of curiosity to understand the world around us. For example, many scientists around the world wanted to know what the DNA sequence of COVID-19 looks like. This research has led us to the realization that there are actually several different strains or cousins of the COVID-19 virus. The results of basic research often serve as the basis for future applied or translational research. So understanding the DNA sequence of COVID-19 will contribute to the development of possible vaccines or treatment to fight the infection. Most basic science research is done at universities, sometimes at companies, or even high school students do research. Did you know that people even do research in their own homes? We call them citizen scientists doing important research in their very own garages. Applied or translational research is designed to answer a specific question or solve a specific problem, and it's intended to have a direct or immediate benefit. Most of this type of research is done at universities, hospitals, and companies. For example, can we generate a COVID-19 vaccine that works to protect humans from getting a severe infection? To do that, we need research to generate candidate vaccines. We need research to test that the vaccines are safe. And finally, we need research to prove that the vaccine does its job and that the research participants make antibodies against COVID-19. And that the antibodies actually protect us from the infection or reduce the severity of the disease. When we do research, we use several different methods. Some examples are experimental research, where we use a control group and an experimental group, and then we compare the two to determine cause and effect relationships. We can do survey research, where we use questionnaires, do interviews, and sample polls. We can take those responses and represent them in graphs and charts, tables, or percentages. In content analysis research, we can analyze texts and media and count the number of occurrences of a particular phenomena. And finally, we can do something called meta-analysis research, where we combine multiple previous existing research studies and their data for additional power. So if we participate in research, we can have an active participation where we provide a sample, like a blood sample, or take a new medication that's being studied, undergo a new trial treatment, or answer survey questions. Or we can have passive participation in research by consenting to allow our data, like what's in our electronic health record, to be reviewed and analyzed. By the way, on our next coffee break, we're going to talk all about research participation, the risks, benefits, and the ethics. So what are the benefits of doing research? Well, research provides answers to important questions like, is the Earth flat or round? Research improves our understanding of biology, health, and disease. Like, how does the kidney work? What goes wrong when the kidney stops working? And how do we prevent kidney failure in the first place? Research increases safety, like which airbag works best in a car accident? And what dose of ibuprofen is safe? Research helps us understand and define best practices. Like, do face masks reduce transmission of COVID-19? And do they work like this? And do they work like this? And how many feet apart is the safest for social distancing? And do you want your surgeon operating on you like this? Peer review is the process by which research is reviewed by other scientists to ensure the research process was done correctly and the correct conclusions were made. This process happens before the research is published. In this era of fake news, we need to ensure that the data comes from high quality research. One high quality research program you can look into is our sponsor today, the All of Us Research Program, where the future of health begins with you. Thanks for hanging out with us today. Until the next coffee break, bye.
I'm curious about what kind of health concerns are going to be researched with once you get all this database in the future?
So that's a really great question. So clinical studies often target one specific healthcare concern and treatment. All of Us is not a clinical study. All of Us is a research program. So we will not be focusing on one specific health concern.
Right.
We will be creating a database of information for our researchers to be able to access that database to research all sorts of things. It could be cancer, diabetes, Alzheimer's. The list goes on and on. We're not entirely sure what that list looks like right now. So right now we do have to create this database, and this cuts our researchers' time in half. So our future healthcare and research could be, you know, expedited, which is fantastic. So it's not a clinical study, and I know that's a little bit confusing, but it is a research program. So when you give your information, you could be part of dozens, if not hundreds, of different types of research.
That's exciting just in itself.
Yeah.
And that information that you provide may not be used like right away. It might be used, who knows,
down the line.
Down the line.
Yeah. And this is one of those programs that you will be contacted in the future to ask additional questions, or you may be asked to come in and give future samples if we run out of samples from you because we've used them all. So there's just a lot that goes into being part of this program. But it's a really important program to join.
So much of what we've done in medicine over the years has not really taken into account individual differences. We're really building a fundamental base of knowledge about how humans stay healthy or get sick and what to do about it. I think the practice of medicine will be altered in profound ways.
Moms, dads, brothers, sisters, people who are healthy, people who are sick. We want to work with you and make our lives better.
The whole idea of precision medicine is to be able to use individual differences to tailor prevention care that they receive.
We're building a set of capabilities with 1 million or more volunteers to figure out how do we enable targeted, customized care for an individual based on as much data as we can get about them.
I'm very excited about having 1 million people in a cohort. It gives us the ability to look at not just common diseases, but rare diseases. When you have 1 million people, even a rare disease, it may affect 100 people.
This is something that we are invested in, and we want everybody who has a perspective to be able to share that perspective.
The more diverse representation we have, the better outcomes we can give back to the public.
Being able to bring communities of color, not only to contribute to science, but to contribute to our ability to understand the nuances within those populations.
It is important for minorities to be a part of this, or we will again be left with medications that are created for really other populations.
It's definitely important to have participant engagement and individuals being partners from the ground up.
With all of the information that we're going to garner from this study, it is going to help with prevention. Prevention is really what the key right now to longevity.
It's about health, it's about disease, it's about behavior, it's about environment. Why not? You know, why not participate? Why not be part of it?
What is the local connection here in Bethel Park?
Yeah, so All of Us Pennsylvania is one of our consortiums for the National Institutes of Health All of Us program. All of Us is located around the entire country. And Pennsylvania was chosen specifically because of its diverse population, its lifestyles, and of course our environment. Us here in Pittsburgh, we have quite a different environment than people who may be inside of a different state. So we found that there was a lot of diverse population here. So the University of Pittsburgh was awarded this grant, right? And Pitt is a research hub. We have incredible research programs going on there, and our database was full of potential participants. And Bethel Park, let's be honest, people don't love crossing bridges or going through tunnels to get to appointments.
You're exactly right about that in Pittsburgh, Kirsten.
Yeah,
yes.
So we have 5 static sites throughout the Pittsburgh area, and Bethel Park opened, you know, pretty much off the bat of our program because we wanted to be able to bring the opportunity to the Bethel Park area, the South Hills area. It's a diverse population full of incredible people. And when we're looking at different backgrounds and culture, we want to make sure that people have the access here in Bethel Park to have their in-person appointment. So All of Us does have an in-person component. Most of our work is done online, but there is a small in-person appointment. And then hopefully we can retain those people to continue with our program. And so we have a clinic here in Bethel Park that they can come and enroll in.
Well, that's wonderful and good news because I do agree that people do not want to cross the bridges in Pittsburgh.
No, they don't.
And so tell me, where is the location of the Bethel Park Program Center?
Yeah, our location is on Drake Road, and it is right behind the Dunkin' Donuts. So,
I know where that is.
Very convenient. It's in an office building, and my colleague Amy will tell you a little more specifically about how to get there.
We are located at 101 Drake Road, which is at the corner of Bethel Church Road and Drake Road. We sit directly behind the Dunkin' Donuts.
Okay.
It is in the St. Clair Commons building. We are on the 2nd floor.
So that's where, if you wanted to volunteer for the program, participants would come there to enroll?
That is correct. The enrollment process is kind of a two-step.
Okay.
First, you have to go to www.joinallofus.org. Or you can download the All of Us app, and that'll take you directly to the program where you can enroll, first doing online consents and surveys. Then you would have to make an appointment at the Bethel Park office for your place to get your physical measurements done, which is getting your height, your weight, and hip circumference. And then we would do 3 blood pressures. Okay. We would then draw your blood and collect a urine sample. And then when all that process is done, you would receive a $25 gift card. No, we want participants to continue to participate in the study. We want to retain people. Mm-hmm. The study is slated for 10 years now. Mm-hmm. And what a participant would do at this point would just continue on doing surveys online.
Okay, so say someone didn't live in Bethel Park in 5 years, they submitted their samples here, they can still be in the program nationally.
Correct. And you don't have, you know, we don't know at this point if there's going to be another in-clinic visit, but if there mm-hmm. was, you could go to any of the enrollment sites. And we also do what we call our mobile service. We can go to outside of the pandemic,
yes.
We could go to libraries, fire halls. We can bring everything.
Community centers.
Correct. So we could bring the program to people that are out of reach to a static site.
Well, hopefully after this COVID restrictions are lifted, that sounds like that would be a wonderful thing to have all of us days
yes.
in different communities and get people to come and participate that way. So we want to obviously encourage our Bethel Park viewers to enroll in the program. And so they have to make an appointment is most important to
correct.
With you first online or by telephone.
You can do online enrolling or scheduling, and or you can call in person. We have a call center that is dedicated to informing participants about the study.
Mm-hmm.
That number is 412-383-2737. After you would complete the consents and surveys, and the consents are very, very important. They're very informative, and there are three different consents. The first one is the primary consent, which is just a general overview of the program.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have the electronic health record consent. That is where we are asking permission to have access to their health record.
Okay.
That is so important because the more information that we have to give researchers, the better. That is a crucial part of becoming a participant. And then the third consent is what is called the genomics consent. And that is where we are asking people permission to have their DNA. DNA is a very big part of precision medicine.
Sure.
Actually, the future of medicine. Genetics is in its infancy at this point. We are learning every day about genetics. Very, very commonly known now with the COVID vaccine.
Mm, yes.
Having DNA was the resolution to finding the vaccine. So just imagine what it could do to the future for different diseases.
You've read a lot about the program and I'm intrigued. Tell us why should our viewers want to participate?
I think that's a really important question to ask. There's a lot going on right now in healthcare and medicine, and the All of Us program is aimed to help the future of our healthcare system. So we want to just make sure that everybody is represented in this program. So if you are at all interested in becoming part of the future of healthcare, we want you to join the program for your children, for your children's children, so that they can have better healthcare for them, so that they are not being treated and test treated the same as the person next to them, because we all are made up differently. And that's a really important part of this program. So do it for your children, do it for your grandchildren, and hopefully our healthcare will just continue to improve, especially right now with everything that we have going on with this pandemic.
Absolutely. I think that's a great motivation that mm-hmm. just by participating, we can make a difference by changing the future of healthcare in our country.
Absolutely.
Well, please tell me, if viewers want to find out more about the All of Us program, mm-hmm. where can they find some more information?
Yeah, so you can find more information to learn more about the program at joinallofus.org. And there you will find some frequently asked questions. You'll find more information about the program, our history, our background. And then you can also begin your enrollment on that website. You can sign up right there and start the online process, which is a very important part of this because you're going to be asked some survey questions. And those are really important to tag along with your information. And then you can also give us a call at 412-383-2737, where one of our local Pittsburgh agents will actually answer your call. You're not calling the National Institutes of Health. You're calling us right here at Pittsburgh. And they can also answer all of your questions that you might have.
Wow. I think it's so interesting and fascinating, and what a great undertaking it is. I know that the goal of the program is to get 1 million participants mm-hmm. to become enrolled and involved. Mm-hmm. And I just want to ask how that progress is going.
So it's going well. Obviously, the pandemic has halted us a little bit with our in-person activities, but we are a little over 300,000 people in the nation enrolled in the program. So we have about 700,000 to go throughout the whole nation. Pennsylvania is responsible for 120,000 individuals.
Awesome.
And we are well on our way to hitting that mark. It's a 10-year program, so we have time, but we really want to get those people in the door and have them represented in this research program.
Absolutely. So that's your goal for Pennsylvania.
120,000.
120,000. Yeah. And our viewers can be part of that,
yeah.
reaching that goal.
One of our slogans is you can be one in a million. So throughout the whole country, you can be one in a million, and it's a very important million.
That's wonderful.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much, Kirsten.
You're welcome. Thank you for having
it's
us.
It's an exciting program.
Yeah.
See, we're Pennsylvania. We're the farmland. Towns and the cities. The home of constant innovation. From this land came a nation's independence. And from the same land will come a healthier future. Because what flows in our veins is more than just data. It's diversity. Vision. Life. All of us have the power to change the world, to embrace the differences inside of us that will lead to answers for generations to come. We're asking Pennsylvania to come forward and stand on this landmark in history, to help unlock the mysteries that bring forth breakthroughs, to do what our state does best. Lead the way forward.
It's been so informative today, and I'm so happy to have been able to share information with all of you about the wonderful research initiative called All of Us Pennsylvania. If you would like to take an active role in creating to help the largest health resource database ever and provide your information that is essential to creating a healthier future for your children and generations to come, then please take some time to enroll today. Your participation not only is going to make history, but it's also going to add to the future of good health for all of us.